Hello friends, so continuing with the subject health education, in that we are dealing with the chapter demography and family planning. Now the first part we have already covered, and second part, that is family planning methods, we have already started. In that we will try to conclude this chapter today. And in this, the methods that are remaining are chemical methods and permanent methods. Now, chemical methods, as the word indicates, so here the chemicals are to be used, isn't it? These chemicals, they stop the progress of sperms completely, or they are totally inactivated, isn't it? So chemically, these methods act, isn't it? And the chemical effect is exerted on the sperms, isn't it? Whatever the activity of the sperms is there, that is destroyed, isn't it? These methods, they intend in killing the sperms, and when the sperms are not available, when they are not active, so in case of females, the ovum will not get fertilized, isn't it? Try to understand the concept how the pregnancy occurs. So in females, in natural methods, we have studied that in monthly cycle, a female egg is produced, and that female egg is fertilized in presence of sperms, and the sperms and ovum, they come in contact at the time of sexual intercourse, isn't it? So chemical methods, they intend in killing these sperms and making them inactive, isn't it? And therefore they act in this fashion, they act as a family planning method, isn't it? Now in this, they are available in the form of semi-solid also, like foam tablets are there in tablet form, in creams form, isn't it? So contraceptive creams and jellies are also available, isn't it? And in this, the oral pills are also available, isn't it? Oral pills, they can be available in the form of suppositories or pessaries also, isn't it? So these tablets or creams or pessaries, they are intended for vaginal use, isn't it? So that we will discuss first, isn't it? Now, chemical methods. Here, the first one is foam tablet. Now, these foam tablets, they are spermicidal agents, and they are inserted deep inside the vagina, isn't it? And there, in presence of moisture, isn't it? There is liquefaction, isn't it? In presence of moisture, the tablets, they, in presence of moisture, they produce a thick foam, isn't it? And this foam reduces the mobility of the sperms, isn't it? And therefore they are totally destroyed. So this foam tablets, they come under chemical method, they act chemically, and also they act as a physical barrier by forming a thick foam, isn't it? Now these chemical methods can be used along with mechanical methods also, like condom, isn't it, which give additional extra protection against pregnancy, isn't it? The other is contraceptive creams and jellies, isn't it? So they are also applied in vaginal area with the help of applicator, isn't it? They destroy male sperms, isn't it? And they are effective if used along with diaphragm or condom, isn't it? Now at body temperature, this cream melts and it produces a thin film of a chemical barrier, isn't it? And in this fashion, it acts as a chemical method of contraception, isn't it? Now the advantages and disadvantages also we must know, isn't it? The advantages are that merits, we can say that they are easy in application, they can be easily used, they are available free at family health healthcare centers, they are not expensive, they do not interfere with sexual pleasure, usually there are no side effects, no medical examination is necessary, isn't it? So these are some of the important advantages associated with chemical methods. The disadvantages are that they are to be inserted deep inside the vagina, and just 10 to 15 minutes before sexual contact, isn't it? They must be applied each time before sex, and in some cases it may cause irritation and burning also, isn't it? And when these are used alone, they are less effective, isn't it? And as I said, they are to be applied 10 to 15 minutes before sexual intercourse. Now, if they are applied for 1 hour before, isn't it? So that will not be, you can say, beneficial, and there may be the risk of pregnancy to occur. So these are some of the important advantages and disadvantages with chemical method. Now in chemical methods, oral pills are there, they are called oral contraceptives also, and they can be asked under hormonal contraceptives also, isn't it? So if the question is asked on hormonal contraceptives, you can describe oral pills also, because these are hormonal preparations, isn't it? Now these oral pills, they are popularly known as oral pills, isn't it? They contain small amount of female sex hormones, that is estrogen and progesterone, isn't it? Now there are many more varieties that are available in the form of oral pills. One is combined pill, isn't it? So here the hormone, that is synthetic estrogen and progesterone, they are present in very small doses. Then its action is to inhibit ovulation, isn't it, of ovum by blocking secretion of gonadotropin from pituitary gland. So the physiological effect is exerted by these hormonal preparations, which will interfere with the ovulation process in case of females, isn't it? These oral pills are to be taken by females. Now this progesterone hormone, that also thickens the mucosa of cervix, which prevents entry of sperm into the genital canal, isn't it? Now there are different types of oral pills, and the family welfare centers, they make available these two preparations free of cost to the eligible females. One is known as Mala D and other is known as Mala N, and the formula is also given, isn't it? They contain synthetic derivative of these female sex hormones. So Mala D contains D norgestrol 1 mg, and other contained is ethinyl estradiol, isn't it, 0.03 mg, and Mala N that contains norethisterone acetate, isn't it, and other contained is same, that is ethinyl estradiol, isn't it? So these pills, they are available in market also, isn't it? They are supplied freely, isn't it, by the government. And here we will discuss the advantages also of this oral pills. So if it is taken regularly, it is 100% effective, isn't it? then it is easy to use, does not interfere with the sexual pleasure, we can say. Then it reduces the risk of anemia because the menstrual bleeding is less when the females take these hormonal preparations. Then they reduce the risk of pelvic inflammatory disease, cyst and uterine cancer, isn't it? And whenever pregnancy is desired, so the pill can be discontinued because it comes under temporary method. So when they are discontinued, so the couple can have sexual contact and pregnancy can occur. So these are some of the, you can say, examples how these packets are available of these tablets. So these tablets, these packet contain contraceptive pills, they contain 28 pills, isn't it? So out of this, daily one pill is to be taken after menstruation, that means after 4 days or 5 days, whatever the days are there of menstruation, isn't it, bleeding, after that this packet is started and it is to be taken regularly for 21 days. Now you can see in the slide that the 21 pills, they contain hormonal preparations, and the red color 7 pills, they contain iron preparation, isn't it? So that is also given to the females so that they may not suffer from anemia. Now when this packet is over, a new packet must be started without fail from the very next day, isn't it? So extra packets also must be available with the female, isn't it? And without break they are to be taken, and then and then only this method will be 100% effective, isn't it? Now some of the disadvantages of this method. So a careful history and prior medical examination is necessary. That means the doctor is to be consulted before starting these oral pills, isn't it? Now there may be some side effects like dizziness, nausea, vomiting, headache. There may be weight gain in case of females, isn't it? There may be bleeding between menstrual periods, then tenderness of the breast, isn't it? It may increase the risk of gallbladder disease and cervical cancer in case of females, being it is a hormonal preparation. Then the other disadvantage is that the female requires strong motivation and self-discipline for taking the pill daily. So she must take pill daily without fail, isn't it? And for that, a awareness and self-discipline is very important. Now these are some of the practical points which are to be followed by the females who are taking oral pills as a method of contraception. So say for example, if a pill is missed for a particular day, for one day, so two pills are to be taken next day and continue as usual. But when there is a gap of more than one day, so in that case the other method can be used as a method of contraception, like condom can be used or any other method can be used, isn't it? Okay, and the oral pills can be then started after the menstrual cycle, isn't it? Now if breakthrough bleeding occurs, now if in between the bleeding is taking place, so one has to switch on to the higher estrogen pill also, because there are different kinds of whatever the hormonal preparations, isn't it? Now, these hormonal preparations, they may contain, as I said, there are two types of hormones in case of females, estrogen and progesterone. So some females may not be, suitable, or estrogen may not be suitable in case of females. So progestin only pill can be taken by those females, isn't it? So these are some of the practical points which are to be followed by the females who use these oral pills as a chemical method of contraception. Now there are different other preparations also, and in hormonal contraceptives, if it is question is asked, so these also can be discussed shortly, isn't it? So progesterone only pill, so the pill also known as mini pill, it contains only progestogen and it thickens the cervical mucous cavity, which prevents the entry of the sperms, isn't it? So mini pills are to be taken throughout the menstrual cycle, and these are not widely used because of its high failure rate. Then other type is once a month pill. It is modified combined pill. It contains long acting estrogen and short acting progesterone. These pills are not in use because experimental results revealed high pregnancy rate and irregularity in menstrual cycle. So irregular periods also are responsible for failure rate. Then other hormonal, you can say, preparations, they are depot formulations. They are long acting hormonal contraceptives. They contain only synthetic derivatives of progesterone hormone. These are available in three forms. So they may be available in injection form, in the form of implants, which are to be given subdermally, and the vaginal ring can be used, isn't it, locally. So this slide also shows again about the hormonal methods of contraception, where oral pills that we have discussed, then these hormonal preparations can be used in the form of injection, in the form of subdermal plants, implants, and the other is the intrauterine devices or vaginal rings. So these hormonal contraceptives, injectables, they are given by intramuscular route, and they are long acting preparations. Their effect in the body is for longer period. Then implants, they are subcutaneous route is preferred. Then in intrauterine devices, so here either the hormonal preparation may be there or non-hormonal, where we have discussed about the copper T, isn't it? So there is no any hormone, but copper is slowly released in copper T, isn't it, which produces its contraceptive effect, isn't it? So that is all about the hormonal contraceptives. And if question is asked on hormonal contraceptives, so you can discuss them easily. Then the last category of the methods is permanent methods, isn't it? And as the word indicates, permanent, so these are to be used when the couple decides that the family has been planned and no more children are desired, isn't it? So permanent methods, they are also called terminal methods also, isn't it? They are also called sterilization. So all of you must remember that in sutics you have sterilization, but here the permanent methods, they are followed in both male as well as female, and in both the cases the sterilization word is also used for the terminal method of family planning, isn't it? So these are to be used by the eligible couples when no more child issue is desired and this sterilization provides permanent protection from fear of pregnancy, isn't it? So pregnancy will not occur if these methods are adopted, isn't it? So any one, either of the partner can go for these methods. As I said, that these methods can be adopted by both, either male or female, isn't it? So here, the two methods are there, vasectomy and tubectomy. Vasectomy is used in case of males, isn't it? It is called male sterilization, isn't it? So it is done in males, isn't it? And it is a simple operation. It is a minor operation, which takes hardly 15 to 20 minutes, isn't it? Now the operation involves a small cut on both sides of scrotum and then a small portion of vas deferens on either side of scrotum is cut and ligated, isn't it? So diagrammatically you will understand this, how vasectomy minor operation is carried out, isn't it? Now this operation that is done and it is not affecting sexual characteristics and sex life in any form in case of male. The sperms are produced but not ejaculated along with the semen, isn't it? So in this diagram you can easily understand, as I said, that how this minor operation is carried out under local anesthesia. So local anesthetic is used and where a small cut is given, isn't it, on both sides of the man's scrotum. So you can see, isn't it, the vas deferens, isn't it, where the cut is given on both the side, isn't it? So vas deferens is the tube which carries the seeds, isn't it, that is the sperms from the testes, isn't it? So when the cut is given, isn't it, they are tied up, isn't it, and they are ligated and sutured, and that will prevent the flow of sperm into the semen, isn't it? And therefore the sperms will not be available for the ovum for fertilization, isn't it? So after this minor operation, the male can enjoy sexual life, isn't it, sex life without any side effect, isn't it, without any drawback or without any losing any other you can say sex characteristics, isn't it? So he can enjoy his sex life as usual as before, isn't it? Now after operation the man can go home, but he is kept under observation for at least 2 hours for any sign, any allergic sign or any sign of shock, isn't it? So the dressing should be examined if there is any bleeding or not, isn't it? So if any bleeding is there, so that must be controlled before he leaves for home, isn't it? Now the certain precautions are to be taken by the males who undergo this vasectomy operation, isn't it? So he should not soil the dressings, isn't it, with urine or feces. He should not wet his dressings, isn't it? So if itching is there, he must not scratch, isn't it? On 5th day after operation, he must go for removal of stitches, isn't it? Then he should not perform any hard work, isn't it, for about 1 week. He should not have sexual intercourse for 8 days, isn't it? Then he must use other method like barrier contraceptive for 3 months, and after 3 months the semen is taken for examination to confirm that whether the sperms are present or not. If sperms are not present in the semen sample, then operation is successful. That is the confirmation, isn't it? So that is all about the vasectomy. Then the tubectomy, which is to be followed in case of females. So it is sterilization of female, isn't it? These permanent methods, they are also called terminal sterilization also, isn't it? Now this is done by resecting a small part of fallopian tube and ligating the sected end. The closing of tubes can also be done by using another method. So apart from tubectomy, isn't it, the laparoscopy technique also can be used, isn't it? The operation can be done through abdominal or vaginal approach, isn't it? So this is a major operation in case of females, isn't it? And it is to be done under general anesthesia or spinal anesthesia, isn't it? As I said, where a small piece of fallopian tube is removed by giving small cut, isn't it? So here, in earlier days, the hospitalization was there for 5 to 7 days, isn't it? And after tubectomy, female can do light work for about 10 days, and after 1 month they can have sexual contact, isn't it? So till 1 month they have to avoid sexual intercourse also, isn't it? So this is how you can see in the slide how the cut is given on both the sides to the fallopian tubes, isn't it? So you can see the small rounds are there, isn't it, on both the side, right hand side and left hand side, isn't it? So where a minor cut is to be given, isn't it, and they are then tight, isn't it? So either by giving cut they are to be tight, or by laparoscopy the fallop rings are to be used, which will block the you can say passage of the ovum, and that ovum will not be able to meet the sperms during sexual intercourse, isn't it? Hence no pregnancy can take place. Now the advantages of these methods are that they are permanent methods, so they no further action is required by either man or woman for preventing conception, isn't it? These operation can be done immediately, isn't it, after delivery or abortion. There are no side effects. These operations are carried out free of cost in government hospitals, at primary health centers, isn't it? And disadvantages are that in vasectomy, female has to get admitted in hospital. It is a irreversible method, isn't it? So these are some of the disadvantages. Now one more important topic in this chapter is about the role of pharmacist in family planning. So the question is asked that write a note on role of pharmacist in promoting family planning. So as a pharmacist, how they can promote family planning? Nowadays we know that in our country there are so many social problems. So many people who are not educated, they are not aware about the family planning methods, and because of poverty, because of other poor housing facilities, so their family size, they get increased, isn't it? So in keeping in view about the family planning, the advantages and other methods, how pharmacist can promote, isn't it? Now pharmacists have close contact with the public, isn't it? He is a, you can say, healthcare service provider, isn't it? To the public, like doctor, isn't it? So most of the uneducated people have psychological fear that family planning is painful, dangerous, harmful, isn't it? And therefore here, pharmacist can explain the use of family planning to uneducated people in a simple way, isn't it? Now, pharmacists can promote family planning by following methods. By propagating usefulness of family planning in right way. So, the family planning methods, they are to be used. They are to be, you can say, explained to the general public, isn't it? So that they get convinced and they start using these methods. Then pharmacist can explain the safety and convenience of these methods also, isn't it? So he can discuss about the safety and convenience. He can advise spacing between the children to the eligible couples. Then he can display family planning posters in hospitals and dispensaries, isn't it? He can guide the people to family planning centers about the other methods, about the other family planning methods, isn't it? About temporary methods and permanent methods. Then he can motivate the public for use of oral contraceptive, hormonal contraceptives, isn't it? Condom. He can establish awareness in community regarding availability of various family planning services. So many people who are not educated, who are living in rural areas, they do not know about the number of family planning methods and services that are available in the government hospitals and primary health centers. So that can be easily explained by the pharmacist to the general public. He can produce a positive attitude to family planning by motivating eligible couples to adopt small family norms. So he can explain the advantages of small family to the eligible couples. Then pharmacists can promote family planning by distributing pamphlets about family planning, isn't it? So in this fashion, this is about the role of pharmacist in promoting family planning, isn't it? So here, this is also very important, and many a times question is asked on the role of pharmacist in promoting family planning also, isn't it? So here we have finished chapter demography and family planning, and after completion of every lecture, the questions are also given to you, important questions which are asked in board exam, isn't it? So keep your notes complete also, isn't it? And if you are not able to understand lecture or any topic, so listen this video twice or thrice, isn't it? And try to understand and complete your notes.